The illustration of two towns, right? There's one town over here, and this is the town of the text, right? Here's the town or the village of the text. And then over here, there's the town or the village that you and I live in, right? These two villages. And what we have to do is we have to get the information from this town or this village into this town or this village. I want to talk you through five steps for doing this. And there's a great resource that can help you with this. It's called Grasping God's Word. And I'll talk to you about some other resources as well, but there's five steps to going from there to here. Let me give you those steps and then we'll sort of walk through them. Step number one, grasp the text in their town. Grasp the text in their town. That's my first duty, my first responsibility, to grasp the text in their town. Again, I'm going to explain these. I'm just giving them to you. Secondly, measure the width of the river to cross. Okay? How wide is that river? Thirdly, cross the principalizing bridge. The principalizing bridge. Cross the bridge. Cross the principalizing bridge. And I'll explain why they call it the principalizing bridge in a minute. Four, consult the biblical map. And then five, grasp the text in our town. Let's look at these in turn. Okay? First, grasping the text in their town. So many times when we read the Bible or when we do Bible study. I hate to even call it Bible study. Oftentimes, you know, we'll read a text and then we'll go around the room and have people comment on, you know, what the text says to them, right? So newsflash, I do not care what the text says to you. Like, not at all. I care what the text says, period. What the text says to you may be helpful, or it may be the worst thing in the history of the world, okay? But what I want to know is what the text says. What did the author communicate to his audience? That's what I'm trying to get to. And oftentimes we skip this text and we try to read the Bible as though it's a modern text and as though it's just sort of, you know, right here, right now, communicating to me type stuff. But you got to go from their town to ours. So step number one is to grasp the text in their town. Here's the question. What did the text mean to the biblical audience? And here we're doing observation. Observation. And we have to start with observation. We can't just run straight to interpretation, right? Which is often what we want to do. We read a text and then we want to interpret it, or we read a text and then we want to apply it. Eventually we have to interpret, eventually we have to apply, but before we can do that, we have to observe, okay? What does observation look like? And here's where that study Bible stuff comes in handy. Questions like this. Who is the author? Who is the author? Who is the audience? By the way, that matters. Who the author is matters. Who the audience is matters. What's the setting? What's the setting? What are the conditions under which the author wrote this to his audience? What type of literature is it? This one is hugely important. What type of literature is it? Is it law? Is it narrative? Is it poetry? Right? Is it apocalyptic? This is very important because We don't interpret those things the same way, right? You can pick up a document. Let's say someone has passed away, and you know you have to you have to go and you're responsible for getting all this person's belongings and everything else. Well, if you pick up this person's will and you pick up a letter that they wrote to their wife or to their children, you're not going to read these the same way. Amen? One of them is a legal document, and you read a legal document with a certain kind of understanding and with certain assumptions. The other one is a personal, intimate document, and you read that in a very different way. In fact, there could be words used in both documents that are the same word but have very different meanings because of the type of literature. Okay? What this means is you don't go to the book of Psalms and find a word there and then go to Genesis and find the same word there and then go to Revelation and find the same word there and say that they all mean the same thing, because one is in the law, one is in poetry, and the other one is apocalyptic. Okay? So we've got to know what type of literature we're reading in order to interpret properly. What's the time period? We need to know the time period. Key words or phrases that the author uses. Theological terms. What's the cultural context? Okay? These are questions that we have to ask in order to understand what the author's intended meaning was. What did he intend to communicate to his audience? Now, that's what I'm going to interpret, and that's what I'm going to imply. I can't just say, he said this, therefore, that's what he's saying to me. No, he said this in a particular place, at a particular time, and in a particular context, and it had a meaning. I need to understand that meaning before I can do anything else.